What is happening to you? Is this it? We're going to the hospital?
I struggle with straws sometimes. I love this water bottle so much, but if I drink too fast, it goes down the wrong hole. I don't have COVID. I'm just joking. We're okay now. Hey, it's Lauren. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to day.
Oh my God, I swear if you look to me.
I know, I'm just seeing if you know, I know. 10 of Vlogmas. If you're new here, it is so nice to meet you. My name is Lauren. This is David.
Hi.
This is Nibs. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for following along on our Vlogmas fun. If you haven't already, please thumbs up this video and subscribe. It really helps out my channel. And it is Thursday. It is 12:30. We've been doing a lot of housekeeping? Housekeeping things at home, not a literal housekeeping, but
no,
just like
paperwork and filling out, you know, when the mail comes and you have to
you have to deal with it.
Just deal with things.
So we've been putting some stuff off for a while. Yeah. So we dealt with that today. So even though it feels like we haven't left the house yet, like we have been productive.
We're making some trades.
Yeah, David just got, We are now investors in stock. It's no big deal.
Well, it's not the first stock we've been in.
No.
We bought Tesla. No, just kidding. We should have done that 5 years ago when we lived in Vancouver. Idiots. If we had invested a couple of grand,
stop. Don't do this.
When we moved to Vancouver, we saw Teslas everywhere. Everywhere.
Which was almost 7 years ago.
I'm almost positive. Nibs, we're trying to have a conversation here. I'm almost positive. I said, you know what? We should put some money into Tesla.
But you didn't.
I know.
You're just all talk.
I said it all the time. Every week, see Teslas and I'd be like, we should buy Tesla stock. And we didn't. And back then it was worth about $50. Today it's worth $650.
Yeah. Idiots.
Idiots.
So we're not making that mistake again. David has a few hunches about a few companies, so we've invested.
Yeah, not heavily.
No.
We're diversified.
We're not doing day trading or anything. We're just throw the money in and then walk
put
away.
I want a put option on. I don't even know what that stuff means. No. I'm a buy it and then put it in a drawer.
And then hope that we make it big.
Yeah. Yeah, so.
Maybe one day, 20 years from now, we'll look back on this video and be like, oh, that's the day it all started.
That was the day.
Yeah.
That was the day.
We'll be watching it from our mansion. Mm-hmm. Where will we live?
But the cool thing is, is that now we're invested in electric vehicles. Not Tesla. We're not going to tell you what we're invested in, because then you're going to run out and buy the stock.
Isn't that what you want?
I don't know
either. Anyway, that was our morning.
Yeah. So we're in the EV market is what I'm saying. It's no big deal, you guys. No big deal.
Should we do some advent calendars?
Yeah.
Okay. Close your eyes. David's coming home. Don't look.
I can do... This is my advent calendar. I can do whatever I don't want.
You know that's a good one.
I don't want it. I want this one. Yeah. No, don't touch.
Okay, my turn. I'm now starting to get bored with mine. What the hell is this?
It's a pine cone.
Oh. It's a pine cone. Oh, it wanted to go to your face.
Always wants to focus on me.
So, what's our plan for today, David?
Well, we know I'm an estate sale that's happening.
So we might check that out.
It's on till 3, and it's 12:30 now, so we've missed it pretty much.
No, we can go.
I don't know if they'll have any cool stuff that we'll want, but...
Maybe, though.
We're only going if they're, they've said in all their emails that they're, COVID, they're taking all the precautions. They're only letting a few people in at a time. So it won't be much different than, a regular store.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll go check it out and see what's up.
Yeah, so we're gonna do that. I have to get coffee. I'm out of decaf coffee. Oh, have to show you though. My friend Amanda.
Oh, this is awesome. Gave, here, just let me get them.
Gave me, no, let's show on the tree. Gave me my Christmas present. Wait till you see this. There's Reese. Reese, AKA Reese's Pieces. And then, where is it? We've got the beauty over here. Nibs, AKA Nibbles and Bits. One of her many nicknames.
It's a pretty...
It's amazing.
It's pretty good.
It's amazing. They look exactly like them. She said it's a local person. Let me see if I can grab the card. Stay Funny Designs. Amanda said that she is the one who designed these amazing ornaments for our tree. What are you guys doing over there?
I'm looking at the snow globe.
Why?
Just cause.
Oh, I had a few people ask if Vince is still alive.
He sure is.
He looks dead, but he's alive.
Oh, he's alive.
There you go.
You just gotta pet him.
Woo. So I realized that I haven't done an outfit of the day in my new mirror yet. So here we are. I've got some maternity leggings on. These are from Blonky, an Australian company. I've got my from Fur Mama to Baby Mama socks on, courtesy of my friend Alex. And then this is a maternity shirt from The Gap. I'm a size medium in this and the pants, if that helps. So David had a moment of pregnancy brain.
I thought it was Friday.
He thought today was Friday.
We're not going to, are you still coughing?
We're not going to the estate sale today. We're going to the estate sale tomorrow. So stay tuned for that. Pregnancy brain.
Come on. Come on.
You just can't help yourself. Another day, another Value Village.
Oh, yeah. World War Z.
That's your favorite.
Yeah, every Value Village you come to, you will find this book on the shelf, either in science fiction or in horror.
It's right here.
Told you, right there. This is a good score, right here, look at this. 1, 2, 3. That's a good science fiction score right there.
Where are we, David?
Where do you think we are?
Greatest place on earth.
Costco!
So David and I have been on the hunt for a pair of like slip-on boots for me. Because I just realized this week that I've actually started swelling a little bit. Because I noticed at the beginning of the week that my rings were a little tight and I couldn't pull them off. And normally I can pull my rings off. They're all like, they're not super loose, but I can get them off. Mm-hmm. And so I just thought, okay, maybe I've just been doing something, I'm sweaty. And then I noticed yesterday that I couldn't get them off and they were so tight that there's like an indent in my finger from them. And I was like, okay, I guess I'm swollen. So I took them off and my hands feel naked. I keep like, I realize how much I play with them because I keep going like this to play with my rings and they're not there. And then I also noticed that my watch that I always wear, which is very loose on my wrist, was only a little bit loose. And I was like, oh, okay. And then the other thing that I've noticed, and this is like what's killing me right now, is my, I think my feet have swollen. Which is the one? I think my feet are swollen. because my Bluntstones, which I wear every day, which are normally, I have to wear thicker socks with them normally because they're so, like, not big on me, but just a bit looser. They're, like, tight. Like, I am. I can feel, like, I feel like it's going to cut off my circulation. It's so tight. So David and I are on the hunt for just something, like, first off, cheap, because it just needs to last me until the swelling goes down. But we went to Value Village to see if we can find, like, a slip-on boot. I got a cool pair of running shoes, which are really comfortable, which I can wear because my Converse are now really tight. So I got, they're just, like, Reeboks.
They're super nice.
So these I can wear, but we're also trying to find something for winter as well. So we checked at Value Village, didn't find anything. We just checked at Costco. We didn't find anything. We did find fries and chicken fingers. So now we're gonna go to Bayshore because I need to get coffee anyway. And I get my coffee at Nespresso at Bayshore. Maybe there'll be something there.
We just checked in on our stocks. We're millionaires.
If we were millionaires, we wouldn't be trying to find these slip-on boots at Value.
Whatever. Village. If we became millionaires because our stock shot through the roof, we would still go to Value Village.
It's so fun. We would. That's true.
We absolutely would.
Yeah. So that's our little update for you. We're going to go to Bayshore now. Fingers crossed to find something. If not, at least I've got those shoes. Those shoes are very comfortable.
Let's make a commitment right now that we will not go into buy baby clothes at Bayshore. We will not go into the Gap or Old Navy.
Okay. Hold us to it.
We don't need any more.
Nope. We won't do it. It's not happening.
Meanwhile, our noses are just like, Pinocchio.
So we're just doing a quick adventure time through a neighborhood that we really like before we hit Bayshore. And if you watched yesterday's Vlogmas, which you should, you'd know what I'm talking about when I say adventure time. And you'd also know David wanted you to see this.
McMansion.
Remember we talked about McMansions?
Yeah. I don't know, you're on the wrong side here. Let me see if I can pull this around.
So we found one with the, like, what is it, the spiral?
Yeah, there's the spiral.
Can you see? So David is not a fan of that.
What a mess. Ugh. But they got a cool camper van there.
Woo! Oh, they do, the Mercedes.
Yeah.
Of course they have a Mercedes camper van.
Super rich.
We are in a rich neighborhood. Ooh, look at this house.
Big bunk. Oh my God, that's beautiful.
That's our jam.
That is it, the mid-century style.
Yeah, that's our jam.
That wasn't built in the 60s or anything, but
they know what they're doing.
They know what they're doing for sure.
Okay, I'll show you this McMansion. David wants you to see the spiral.
Yeah. Spirals, they never look good. Never.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about.
Sorry if that's your house. I'm sorry. You're a millionaire. Like, this house is worth...
You're doing just fine.
You're doing fine. I'm sure this isn't gonna...
Better than us. Okay, we found one more David wants you to see.
Yeah, this is... Okay, so start on this side of it.
Okay. It's huge, first off.
So, like... It's just, look at all the different components. On the left, it's got this old Victorian, but then look at the right, and it's just, it doesn't hold up. It's just one of these put to, oh God. Oh, I can't even.
Tell us how you really feel, David.
But watch this. I want to show you something else.
What are we looking at here?
If you've ever wondered how to tell if you've made it in life.
Oh.
I want to show you something. And now that I've pointed it out, you're going to see them everywhere. How do you know if you've made it in life? You have lions at the end of your driveway.
It's true.
Okay? So these people, although I'm not a big fan of their house, they're next door neighbors. They've made it.
They've made it.
Because they have lions at the end of their driveway. One lion, two lion, and then they've got more up here because it's a big U.
Yeah, these people
are... You getting this? Look at this. Lions.
They also have a basketball court.
That's how you know. If you've ever wondered if you're successful, just look at the end of the driveway. Do you have lions at the end of the drive? You're a failure. No, you don't have... No lions? You're a failure.
So no luck at Bayshore with my boots. So I think we're going to try a bunch more Value Villages tomorrow because I feel like that's our best bet. And we love going to Value Village, as you know.
Us? No.
And those shoes were such a score. Oh
yeah, you got them cleaned up. They look great.
Yeah. Anyway, We're making dinner right now, and David saw tofu at Costco the last time we were at Costco, and we don't make tofu that often, but you love tofu. Mm. You love it. So we bought some, and we've been making it, and we kind of just came up with this super easy recipe to make the tofu really, really good. And so we thought we'd share it with you. This is kind of David's concoction.
I don't remember it. I hope you
I know.
Do.
I remember.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
So we thought we'd just show you how we make the tofu. And if it sounds good to you, you can make it yourself. It's very easy. It's very good. I like tofu, but I don't love tofu. But I really, really like this. This is good. Is it okay if we make our recipe now, Nibs? Is it okay if we do that? So, the ingredients that you need for this is some
tofu.
Extra firm tofu. Firm or extra firm? This is extra firm. Then you want some sriracha. Not on my face. Not on David's face. I can't get this camera to focus. Sriracha. And your hoisin sauce of choice.
Do you like hoisin sauce?
No. Okay, let's make this tofu. Okay, so the first thing that you want to do is, if your tofu is in water, which ours is, you want to just strain it and then dry it out. So I usually grab some paper towel, put it on the cutting board, strain this. So put it on the cutting board and then just like try and soak up all the water. If your tofu is really, really, really wet, you can...
I don't know why that was a lot of really.
This tofu is wet, but if yours is really, 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 really wet?
If your tofu is really wet, you can also put something heavy over top and it helps like squeeze out the water. All right, David, show them how you cut it.
With a knife. There's no Gordon Ramsay business going on.
You don't want the pieces too big, but you don't want them too small.
No. Maybe he's going to hold back out, baby. And there you have it. Enjoy.
Okay, so when your pan is all heated up, add the tofu. And we'll fry it up for a few minutes. Okay, it's just about done. I'm just gonna add a little more hoisin to it. Okay, so it doesn't take very long to make, and as you saw, we just fry it up a little bit, add the hoisin, add the sriracha. You pretty much just add to your liking. Fry it up some more, and when it starts to look really crispy and you know you're gonna take it off the pan, I just like to add a little bit more hoisin just to kind of keep it moist. Moist but crispy. So this is what it looks like.
It's really in the cuts. That's what really makes it.
You want to try?
Here's your cut, of course. Nice.
Yeah? Do we do good?
I love that. Yeah, of course.
Okay. Oh, it's hot.
Yeah.
Definitely try this out. Really easy. We usually have it with like stir fry, like with rice and veggies. Yeah. Now we're gonna eat. So we just had dinner. It was so good. Oh my gosh. David made me take the tofu away from him because he was like, I'll just eat this entire thing. And we want that to last two nights, David, not one. Anyway, I am going to edit this vlog now and keep doing laundry and hopefully get a good sleep. So I will end this here, but I hope that you enjoyed Vlogmas Day 10. And again, make sure to like this video and subscribe. And I will see you tomorrow for Vlogmas Day.
Stop looking at me.
11. Bye. What are you doing?
I think the question is, what are you doing?
Rolling out my glutes.
Why?
Because they're tight.
Why?
Because I'm pregnant. And I'm carrying an extra 25 pounds. This relieves my buttocks. That's not your advent calendar. Oh my god, it's gonna break under her weight.
You calling her chonky?
Meow. Meow. Meow.
Not today.
You gonna talk to me? Meow. Meow. Meow.
You wanna spank your tofu.